Right, guys, welcome back to another episode of Crossing Swords. As always, I'm Andrew.
And I'm delighted to be able to bring to you another guest.
Do I do the thing?
Do the thing.
Okay. It's getting hot in here, so take off all your clothes. I am getting so hot, I want to take my clothes off. Unfortunately, due to copyright, that's all we can play.
Sexy, though. I feel sexier.
I definitely feel sexier.
I feel somewhat sexy, I guess.
Yeah.
I was more impressed by the panic on the button of copyright as you tried to hit pause and nearly missed.
Do you know what's ridiculous? Last week we recorded the coronation special. Anyone who hasn't listened, please
go back and listen to that. You've got to hear this.
And we played two bits of music in that episode. One was the national anthem, unsurprisingly. And the other was a Sex Pistols song. And I got really annoyed on pod because Jake made me play it for like 20 seconds. And I'm like, we are going to get a copyright
strike. I forgot how long the intro was.
And then I edit the episode, upload it to YouTube. And lo and behold, we get a copyright strike for the fucking national anthem. And not the Sex Pistols. And I honestly...
I think, what did I say to you? Fuck the king.
Yeah, something like that.
Oh, you know, Charles is running a tight ship now. Like, he wants his royalties, mate.
Mate, he's not fucking around.
His team is not fucking around. We never got copyright strike for the Queen.
No, she never copyrighted.
Is it because it's a new release?
It's a remix.
Yeah, hers has been out, like, it's...
70 years old.
So what is it? Is it 60 years and it becomes public property?
No, but
property?
The Sex Pistols aren't 60 years and we didn't get copyright.
No. But in the law, if a song has been out like 60 years or something, it becomes.
Yeah, but then how long has God Save the King been around?
My point is, the Queen was at least 70 years, right? King.
Yeah. It was the Royal Opera or whatever they are. Do you know what I mean? The Royal Orchestra.
Never liked those guys. No. I always said, didn't I, that they were probably my least favourite opera people.
Yeah. Never trust someone who's flinging around a pokey stick. They can never be trusted.
That's what I say about you, yeah.
Right, so we have a guest on.
Hello.
Guys, for all those who don't know, this is Andrew.
Yes.
Also
Andrew.
Very tempted to nick your intro and see if anyone noticed.
Do it. Do it.
What's our intro?
Hi, guys, and welcome to another episode of Crossing Swords. I'm Andrew.
Yes, and I'm quite happy to go with that as a backup if it ever doesn't work out with this guy, quite frankly.
Yeah, I mean, do we continue to call him Andrew? Because I don't call him Andrew normally.
I don't call him Andrew.
No, we call you Lil.
That's going to stick with me till I die.
Yeah, but then I'm always known as Big. Like, the only person who calls me anything else is Leanne.
Now, do you know what's funny is sometimes I call you Andrew. I've been in the most intimate settings with, like, Big and Ash. Ash still refers to him as Big, and I genuinely love it.
Yeah.
But I think I actually call you Andrew and then his lop.
Because I call him Dougal.
That too, to be fair.
It depends where I am.
And sometimes it's his or something like that.
If I'm at football, it will be his lop or Roo. And yeah. if I'm anywhere else, it is Dougal.
Yeah.
But I think that's the benefit out of being the Andrews. You don't have to follow the nickname like everyone else. Because you're like, well, I'm not talking about me. Unless you do that weird thing where you're like in the third person, everything. I, Andrew.
Yeah. But like,
we should do that on an episode. We should go through a spell. We should third person it.
How do we do that?
Jake suggests that we...
You made me feel really stupid for a second. I was like, third person.
What we're learning from this episode and the last is, doesn't take much.
It really doesn't. Bro. Honestly, I did homework with my nephew the other day, right? And he's what? Oh, I'm going to get myself in trouble now.
This is basic maths.
He's in...
school.
Primary school. I want to say he's like 8, 9? 9 sounds right.
We'll go with it.
I like how you're looking at us like we know.
We did basic maths and basic English, and genuinely, he was teaching me in the end. I honestly, it was dreadful. I felt so stupid.
Well, at least we know the future's in good hands.
Yeah.
Better hands than ours.
Yeah.
I was about to say, have you seen what we've done? We've not been great.
We've not done well.
No.
I refer you to my earlier point, fuck the king.
Nothing's going well for us at the moment.
Us personally or us as a generation?
Both.
I don't know. I mean, we've got a guest.
Yeah.
I think things are going pretty well for us.
It's going all right.
We've got good numbers.
We have got good numbers.
Things are going pretty well, I think.
Yeah.
And the country's fucked, but we're kind of...
We're just like floating on the top of the sewage.
Yeah.
Just pouring
if it's
around.
A, if, yeah. It's a, if it's a pond of sewage with a little hope of lily pad floating on the top.
You have no idea what you're talking about right now, do you?
You know, I started the sentence and I didn't know where I was going to go with it, if I'm honest.
I have this mental image of Jack, of like Jake doing a Drax and being like, I know metaphors. They don't go in my head, I catch them.
Yeah, basically me and Drax.
Yeah.
I get metaphors.
Exactly.
I get, you know.
You catch them immediately.
I get them.
Yeah.
We all understand them and we're all on the same page.
Yeah. Look, I'm not judging, bro. I didn't know what the third person was.
Or what an 8-year-old's like English and math homework was.
Or how old your nephew was.
To be honest, it was English I struggled with more.
I know those feels.
Yeah, but then you have an excuse, though.
Yeah, but tell that to people at work, because they're like, just get on with it.
I wouldn't have thought you're allowed to get away with that nowadays. Isn't that like discrimination?
Yeah, but when you like, that was always the problem in school. For those who don't know, I am dyslexic certified.
And can I just say, right away, we've got to the point, even though it was not in intention to come on to talk about dyslexia, you've already gotten to the point quicker than Matt Hancock when he went into the jungle and said, I'm there to raise awareness about dyslexia, and basically just didn't mention it for like 4 weeks.
When he was paid, what was it, 250 grand?
Yeah, that appearance.
When he tried to start his own media pursuit because he basically gave up on politics.
That appearance.
Well, I don't think he gave up on politics. I think he gave up on him.
You've immediately got straight to this dyslexia quicker.
I can't spell dyslexia, efficiently. But I got there.
You remembered it. Was it daily sex or something
so
like that?
Dyslexia.
But isn't that wrong? There's no A in dyslexia. No, there is at the end.
Are people allowed to have daily sex?
Am I dyslexic?
Is that a thing?
You can do.
You can have it daily.
Women tend not to let you, though.
Because all the women I've been with have said that that's like medically not allowed, and they've kind of really shut me down on that.
I think they just didn't want to have sex with you.
Yeah, well, I was just wondering. I mean, I'm a good faith.
Do you get to have daily sex?
I can't spell it.
But do you get to have it?
I don't kiss and tell.
That's a good man. Smart man.
You do it, though. Come on.
Have you told your missus you're coming on here?
Yes, she laughs at me.
Nah.
Come on,
why'd
bro?
She laugh at you?
Because she just thinks that everything I do is nerdy.
This is 100% nerdy and it's self-indulgent.
I mean, I definitely bring a lot of the nerd.
But then at the very last minute, got like really interested. So she was just like winding me up, but decided on the 11th hour to be like...
But she's 100% going to listen to this.
Now, 100%.
I'm not going to say her name. Obviously.
If I mention her name, will you play that clip?
No, you can't say her name. Not without his permission.
Oh, yeah.
How much is it worth?
Right, okay.
So if it's him, it's zero. He doesn't want to press it that much.
I don't give out money. It's not my thing. It's not my style.
Would you like to say my missus's name to make you feel better?
I would love to mention Leanne.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth!
Right, well, let's segue very quickly. How long have you known us?
God. That's a question. So we was high school.
Yeah. I reckon I was probably in year 9 when I met you, maybe. Maybe year 10.
I think it was a little later because I think I would have been year 8, year 9, somewhere around there.
Yeah.
I imagine.
So how old would you have been?
But I think I've known Jake long.
Well, I don't think we should establish, bring maths into the equation given how you started the conversation today.
It's got to be like 15 years or something now.
Yeah.
Have you known me?
Yeah, because I think I knew Dan. I'm going to just drop names here, left, right and centre. I knew Dan from when my parents were at the social club and you were friends with Dan.
Oh, yeah. We'd go up there once in the blue moon with him, yeah. And Alex as well.
So in some weird way, I knew Jake first. And then.
That's fair.
But I spent more time with you.
Steady, mate.
I know.
Probably,
be professional.
Probably happier to be with you than me. I feel like you give a more sort of generally pleasing presence.
Do I?
It's a better cuddle.
What, mate?
Padding in the right places. That's all I'm saying.
Exactly.
Yeah, it was.
That's what the ladies dig as well.
It was a disguised compliment, but it was still aimed at someone other than me, and I just feel like maybe let's throw.
I like cuddling you, bro.
Yeah, thank you. Let's throw a few of them this side of the table. That's all I'm saying. Let's
look. You're gonna have to learn. You need to be a little bit nicer.
My ego gets stroked during this a lot.
No, I'm not having it, especially after the behind the curtains here of me and Jake in the gym this morning.
Yeah, boy.
Yeah, boy.
Getting them gains.
Yeah. Getting them gains. So it was a bit of a workout this morning, wasn't it?
It was. And for some reason, we went, instead of, normally we're like, oh yeah,
was
well
that before
buddy.
The gym, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
In the showers. we did it in a backwards order this morning.
Yeah, a little bit.
We mixed up the order, so some of the exercises were a bit harder than normal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That happens.
It's good though, I enjoyed it.
It was very good.
What did you do? Cardio, weightlifting, bit of both?
All weights.
Come on, look at us, bro.
I should have known.
You see these muscles? Yeah. Come on,
you know,
man.
I was just trying to play it cool. Come on, I didn't want to go too deep.
You know what they say? Like, you do weights in the gym, cardio at home. That's all I'm saying.
Or you didn't kiss and tell.
Well, with him, it's different. Like,
I want you taking my cardio.
I'm quite open about it.
Yeah. That's fair. Yeah. Have you got any standout memories of us that make you laugh, or any awkward ones? Or
I think the defining memory I have for Jake, and that summarizes him, has
I'm
to
not
be
sure
from,
I like where this is going.
Has to be from Dave Stagdy.
What happened?
In the curry place.
Oh yeah.
What did you do in the curry place?
All right.
You, I don't
okay.
remember
Let's
this.
Just set
the,
let's
I remember just, I remember that curry house that right. had the UKIP.
Yeah, that was the one. Yeah, that was the
same night. And there was genuinely like high ups where from like, UKIP there, weren't there?
Yeah. So it's better than that.
It was their party conference.
It was their party
no, conference. Or the BNP yes, or something.
I do UKIP.
Was it UKIP? It was UKIP.
It was definitely UKIP. And but then, where was Farage? Already had he left at that point?
I don't know.
Anyway, sorry.
And then also on that night, which is hilarious that UKIP were in there, I think Interpol turned up and like kicked yeah, out.
Did like a raid
kitchen.
In the kitchen.
A bloke ran out.
And all of us were just
kitchen.
When he ran, all of us were just like, I hope he's done mine.
Yeah. I hope well, he's already cooked. We had to wait a while anyway, yeah. hadn't we?
And that is where I think the setting of this story comes. All right, I just want to. We all know what I can get hand it.
So we obviously got ordered curry. And they were arguing me because over onion bhajis, and I was like, I don't really eat them. Like, I don't. If I eat onion bhajis, like I have them with a main.
It was yeah. like a set menu.
And they brought them out as a starter, so they put them down in front of me, and I was like, oh okay. And then Jake, genuinely without missing a beat, looks up at me and goes, "Are you going to eat those?"
Because like, he just said like, "I don't. I'm not that.
Yeah, I'm not that
like, bothered about it.
I can wait."
And I was really hangry.
But he didn't ask like, "Oh, can I have them?"
Just, are you going to eat them?
He went, are you going to eat them? And I was like, no, I'm going to wait for my main. And then basically he won't give them to me and then nick them.
So I was like, you can have mine when it comes, but I need to eat now.
He turned into like a gremlin on me. And like full blown just.
It wasn't my proudest moment, but.
Do you know what the ridiculous thing is though? If you showed people a picture or two of us, man, which one of these would have angrily gone after food at a night out? It wouldn't be you.
I lost fingers.
I can believe it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look, I think that there's a few, I think a few friends of mine that have probably had shared moments with me at my hangriest.
Well, you just straight up steal from me.
I once.
When your friends see you at your hangriest, I don't think they have many fingers left.
After no, and I mean,
not if they're holding food.
I would say I wasn't at my hangriest, but also that night, there's someone's birthday when I just went and had two dinners. And I just stormed off and went to Mackie D's because I couldn't
believe I didn't blame you
for that though at all.
The thing is, first off, we were on a night out none of us really wanted to be at, do you know what I mean? It was a particular person's birthday. And then we got there, found out she hadn't booked anything. We had to play, I think, bowling first, didn't we? Mm. And then we stood outside.
I think that was it. It was just that we turned up and it was like, okay, so we're going to go. She, you know, it was like, let's go for a meal and go bowling. It's like, cool. And so it's like, so what are we doing in what order kind of thing? And it's yeah. like, I don't know, I haven't booked anything. Like, on a Friday night.
the worst part was, is that it was all done weeks in advance of this is what we're doing.
Yeah.
yeah, yeah.
And then we got
no
there.
We knew. Yeah. We knew. And we knew what time we were meeting.
Yeah. But nothing had been booked.
Yeah. So I can't blame you on that one.
No, and you were a lot calmer when you'd had a couple of nuggets.
I would say generally, if you see me in a really bad mood,
just give you
chuck
a
me a couple
Kat.
Of chicken nuggets or a Kit Kat or something, and I'll probably be all right in 5 minutes.
Yeah,
it's very true.
Right, any standout memories of me?
I think for you, and walking into your house probably has to be from when we went on holiday together.
Yeah,
and that
hilarious. That was an amazing holiday.
It's a great holiday. I still got.
I've got it in my notes as one of the things I was going to talk about. Because one of the things we did loads on that holiday. Like, your mum was like the best haggler on the planet.
Can I just say, I'm glad I didn't jump in early because I was about to make a joke when you were like, we did loads, and I was about to make the obvious joke. And then the next line was, and your mum was like, oh, so, oh, that's a good turn.
Like, I remember us actually going into like a licensed sports store, and your mum wanted to haggle with the people there, and you literally stormed out and was like, I'm not fucking doing it. I'm not.
There's one thing when you go to like a market and there's nothing marked up and it's like, oh, how much yeah. is this? And
it's
they're
the
like,
game.
Oh,
it's the game.
It's different yeah. when you walk into effectively Adidas or Nike.
Yeah, it was like a proper,
like a label.
It was like sports, their
much.
Version of Sports Direct. Yeah.
Walking into Apple and being like,
it's just a straight, yeah. it's just a Turkish night shop. It was just yeah. Adidas or Nike in Turkey.
Yeah.
And my mum went, no, I don't want to pay this much.
Well, then don't pay it.
You can leave. But no, like, we did a load of excursions. I remember we went on like this weird river trip where we like rode for the day out to the ocean from, do you remember that?
When we went
and we both canoeing. Got ear infections.
Yeah, when we went canoeing, yeah. And then the side of our canoe had a hole in it.
So we had to empty it.
Mate,
we
my favourite thing about some of these places when you got the health and safety.
He was the one having to, and then you came, if I remember correctly, you like fucked up your arm.
Because it's just like fiberglass. Effectively, like all the fiberglass off the side, and the hole was next to
me. And it was jagged, it was like broken.
Health and safety is just a different ball out there, and I love it.
The thing is, though, for
their health and safety out there, by the way, is my version of health and safety when it's all like, well, when you're like, no one's gonna die.
We went on to do as well, because we did that, both got ear infections from going in mud baths. He fucked up his arm, and then we went on like a boat trip around loads of little islands. That was amazing. But the topper of it all was doing bloody paragliding. Yeah.
You should see that now, because...
Mate, I have. Honestly, I've YouTubed it, because I've like tried to show like family this is what it looks like, so I can't find the old DVD of it.
Did they film it there, like a DVD?
Yeah. You hold the GoPro for them.
And they just...
No, it's cool.
But when I remember going up there, I mean, first off, I didn't know what it was I was agreeing to. I thought it was the one off the back of a boat.
You've said this before, and I was like, "How? At what point driving away from the ocean up to the hill?"
It was the night before, wasn't it? It was the night before. Like we were staying in a villa, and we were sharing a room. And I remember you being like, "I'm really like nervous, excited about the paragliding tomorrow." And I was like, "Oh, me too." But it's all right. It's, you know, you've got a wire. And he was like, "What do you mean?" And I was like, "You have a wire, don't you? It's connected to the boat."
He's like,
"He's like, we're going up like a mountain, mate." And I was like, "How are they going to get the wire from the top of the mountain to the boat?" And then I just had this moment where I went quiet. He didn't say anything, and it just clicked in my head what was happening, that we were running off a mountain. And I was like, "Oh shit!"
I think the weirdest part though is that, from where the villa was, is we could see the mountain.
Yeah.
And I think I'd pointed to you a few times and said, "Oh, wait, that's the paragliding." And you hadn't figured it out at that point.
No, I haven't.
He was like, "There must be a lake beyond it."
Also, I remember my dad being furious, because the one rule he gave me before going away was nothing dangerous. And because I thought it was the one off the back of a boat. Like,
in your defence, would you class that as dangerous?
Oh, God, yeah.
Yeah. If you were to watch the videos now, you'd be like, "Mate, that looks so safe as fuck." But when we did it, it was like, honestly, we went up on this little like flatbed lorry sort of, or like truck sort of thing.
You're lucky you got him here to back you up on this, because otherwise this is sounding dangerously genuinely. Like when Alex and Al thought they were being hounded by a mountain goat.
Nowadays, you can go up there, so there's a restaurant at the top.
There's a fucking cable car and shit.
Yeah, there's a cable car now that you can get on.
Shame, because I love a vernacular railway. That would have been cooler.
But you go up to this cable car, and it's 170 feet up or something now, and there's a restaurant up there. It's lovely. But when we went back, it's basically, you start off on this nice normal road, and then you get halfway up, and then it just disappears, and you're basically on a dirt track.
On the side of a mountain.
With the width of the Jeep is slightly bigger than the road. So part of the wheel is like hanging off the edge as it's like crumbling away.
And this fucking truck we're on, no seatbelts. We're basically sat on a bench on either side of the back of it and just holding the side of it.
So if the driver gets it a bit wrong, you're all dead.
Yeah, what's the good news is, though, is you're probably more likely to die on the journey up than you are coming off of it.
If I remember to, what I'll do, I've got the old photos of me doing it and what it looks like at the top of the mountain, and I'll put that in a post with a screenshot from a video of what it's like at the top of this mountain now. Because we went when I was 18.
Yeah, I think so.
Because your parents were letting me drink because I was legally allowed to.
Technically in Turkey, I was legally allowed to, because I think it's only like 16 anyway. So I think we both were.
Were you drinking?
No.
You didn't drink then.
I don't really drink
You didn't
then.
Drink then, did you?
No. I don't really drink. I was on the sauce. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, you were hit. Big Daddy Big hits it hard.
I was about to say, a whiskey every 20 minutes.
Fucking needed it.
And that was just to wash down the beer.
At the start of the day, he was putting on his swimming shorts, getting ready for a go in the back of a boat. And then before you know it, he's being driven on a Jeep off the side of a mountain.
I remember there being like a vaguely attractive girl on the truck up with us. So I couldn't let myself look as scared as I felt.
That's why they put them there.
Because not only did I only just the night before realise what it was we were actually doing, the other part I was nervous about was I had no shoes with laces. All I had with me was one pair of shoes and a pair of flip-flops, and the pair of shoes were canvas shoes. that didn't fit me properly, and I was wearing those to run off a mountain.
I like how he remembers the girl on there. I was too terrified. I was basically well, this is the thing.
You'd done
mountain.
It before, though. Yeah, so like,
but I'm terrified of
and
heights.
We did it with your dad, and your dad was just like, yeah, all right, we're fine.
He's cash.
I'd love to give it a go. I've never done it,
honestly,
and I would love to.
I couldn't recommend it more. You should, if you ever go to Turkey or anywhere that does it, do it, because it's worth it.
So you get to the top. Yeah. And it's all nice now, but even
it was
like,
a patch of dirt with this weird brick building sort of thing in the background.
And an ambulance.
I don't remember the
There is one ambulance that sits there. But let's be
What's
fair.
What's the ambulance doing? If you need help, it's too late.
Yeah, if you fall out, like, the ambulance is there to give. But if you get in the ambulance, it's still going to take you 45 minutes to get down the mountain. Like,
yeah,
it's quicker just to go off.
It was one of these situations where if anything went right, you know. Yeah. Yeah.
And I remember they went, right, who wants to go first? And I'm like, not me. And then my instructor goes, yeah, we'll go. And I'm like, wait, what? I want to see someone else do this.
I know. The best part
was, I remember vividly, because the way they do it is they unfurl the parachute.
Yeah, and then you
they
go
wait
to
for
fun.
The wind to build up. They like get you to move around a little bit to catch the wind. And then you start slowly walking to make sure it's going, and then all of a sudden you just have to start.
Yeah, you can't commit and then jump off the cliff with a flat parachute.
What they do, luckily, is they have like a bloke, literally, whose job it is to hold the guy by the straps, isn't it? Yeah. And then just stare at the parachute.
And there's like
at any point the wind drops, he'll stop you so that you don't just go running off the edge of the cliff.
And there's like two blokes at the front who are basically just skipping stones, waiting for the dust to come up so they can watch the thermals come off the mountain.
Yeah. And all I remember was he starts going, and I found out I'm going after him. So I'm like, right, okay. So as long as I see him survive, we're fine. And as he's literally about to run or starts running, his parachute just drops. So they suddenly go, no.
I went through several pairs of pants that day.
Yeah. All I remember was hearing you screaming going off the edge.
The best part is you then hit the thermal. So then we must have shot up. We instantly shoot up once we gone. And we floated around and come back around. And I must be another 50 feet above where we took off afterwards. And they said they'd tell it was me, because all they could hear was the swearing. As I'm like,
because I remember it, like, as you start running, you think, like, fuck, am I going to get to the edge? But you don't. You're maybe, like, even as far as 10 paces away from the edge. And you start, like, picking off. And next thing you know, you're off. But I remember, like, we sort of calmed down, because you have to sort of sit in this seat that's in the parachute. And I'm holding the camera for the guy. He's in full control. And he's just chatting away to me. And then asks me if he was my boyfriend. And I was like, no, he's just my mate. We're here with his parents. And he was like, oh, you have a girlfriend? I did at the time. So I was like, yeah. And I was like, what about you? And he was like, I have two at the moment.
Oh, great. Great.
I was like, wicked.
Let's hope not. They're not both waiting for us at the bottom.
Do you know what I mean? But then I remember he was like, oh, look at your friend. And you were fucking spiraling. And he was like, you want to do that? I was like, no, fucking don't, mate. We'll just tell you our time.
So my guy went to me, and I'm terrified. I'm sitting there the whole time. I'm hating it. I don't know why I keep doing it to myself. I've been like three times. I keep going, and I don't know why.
Well, how has he been three times, and I've not been once?
Because you've not been on holiday with him.
You need to come to Turkey, mate.
And also, the great thing about all of this is it was dirt fucking cheap. I can't remember how much it was,
but now,
it was something like £80, I think, we paid for the week stuff.
Yeah, it's not much more.
Now, when you say you can sort me out.
Well, you know, depends what you're after, mate.
You know what I'm after. Young adventure, children. Exciting. Young children.
I've heard that's definitely
the thing is, I was gonna say, like, you know, a little bit of company at night. I better not follow that.
You want a new smile? Go to Turkey. You want a new hairline? Go to Turkey. You want a new child? You know, there's rumours.
I think I can neither confirm nor deny.
I'm happy with my child status. I'm happy with my hairline and my teeth. But I think Turkey's great. I mean, I've been to Turkey and I've really enjoyed it. I did a couple of excursions myself and they're great. I like the idea of doing a kind of week away and you do half of it, it's just nice relaxing by the pool, by the beach kind of thing. And then the other half, you get a few days or afternoons where you go and do something mental, like you go and do a paragliding, you drive up into the mountains on one of the Jeep safaris or some shit like
Honestly,
that.
Honestly,
you know
Turkey's
I mean?
One of the most beautiful countries I've ever been to. I would love to go back again. And we went to, for anyone who'd like to see this mountain, it's in Alludeniz.
Alludeniz. If you Google Blue Lagoon, Alludeniz.
Yeah, that's what that's when I couldn't remember the name of it, I remember Blue Lagoon because that was what we flew over as we're paragliding. And literally, you'll see in the videos, if you look it up on YouTube, you land on like a patch of grass on a high street, essentially, aren't you?
On the
beachfront.
On the beachfront.
I mean, you'd have seen it, but you would have just seen glimpses of it as it spun past you as you were doing like full 360.
And I remember the guy saying to me, like, oh, mate, when we come into land, I'll tell you when to start running because you have to run to land. And I was like, oh, okay, cool. I took that as he'll tell me when to start running. And we're getting in closer and closer and closer. And I'm just like, he hasn't said to start running
yet.
Should
have just done the cartoon thing, just like legs going in the air.
Well, you don't want it to look too emasculating. You want to land with style.
I think you can probably put dignity and masculinity out of the picture at that point.
I came in arse first.
Yeah.
As is my way.
Trying to save your dignity by not running. You landed on your arse to lose all your dignity.
Well, I hoped that wasn't going to happen.
Even though you were essentially told that's what will happen.
Well, no, he didn't. Well, I guess I hadn't done the mental math. I thought in my head, even up until like the second before I hit my arse, I'm like, he's going to tell me when to start running. Yeah. I'm naive. Cute. What can I say?
No, yeah, I'll go with that.
Yeah.
But it's on my list. It's on my list of things to do. Yeah. Maybe I should add it to my 31 at 30. Do you guys know that I'm doing a 31 at 30?
I saw you tweet something about it and I was like, that sounds so Jake.
It's just different, isn't it? It's fun.
I guess it's a way to stave off midlife crisis, isn't it?
I'm not quite that. I'm not quite there, mate.
No, but you absolutely would have a midlife crisis.
100%. I would get a bike or a convertible. 100%.
Do you know what? I would pay money
to see me on a big bike.
On a Harley or something. Just like, yeah.
But I could see Jake going like the full bean. Like, he'd get the stick on tattoos. He'd have like the bandana, full levers. Yeah.
Would you ever get a tattoo?
On my list of 31 to 30, I've got it's either or. I'm open to either a tattoo or piercing.
Because we've both been tattooed.
Yeah.
Tattoo or piercing.
Have you been pierced?
But it would be like ear or something.
I got pierced when I was like 4.
Unbelievably, that frightens me.
Did you say 4?
So much more.
4. Yeah, 4 years old is when I got.
Do your parents just hate you?
Yeah, pretty much.
Honestly, I thought you said, I've got 4 piercings. Yeah. And I was like, instantly doing mental maths. I was like, well, there's not one on his nose. I didn't see it on his ears. That means there's at least one on a nipple. And we're possibly looking at a Prince Albert. Honestly, that was what started running through my mind. But no, you were 4 years old. Sorry.
That's where your mind just starts. That's
how did you? What happened when you got pierced at 4 years old?
Parents.
I wanted my ear pierced. I went to a shop. They said that the child might cry.
Were you on your own? Or?
No, my parents were there. And they were like...
Was this in Turkey?
No, it was in England.
So they just didn't give a shit.
It was in England. It's
like, yeah, you want your child pierced? Fine.
I remember.
You could still get your baby's ear pierced now if you wanted to.
And I remember there was some person who stood outside basically seeing a small child getting his ear pierced waiting for me to start crying. And apparently it went in, I jumped, and then I was like, oh, that's it, thank you, bye. And then that was it, and the woman just walked off like really upset, like, oh, I didn't see a small child start crying.
Yeah, it's on my list, my 31 to 30. So this year, for those that are curious, I'm going to be 31 years old. And I want to do, between this birthday and the next, 31 new things that push me out of my comfort zone.
The weird thing is, out of everyone I know, you're probably one of the more adventurous people in terms of what you're willing to try and go for. So the fact you feel the necessity to...
I take that as a compliment.
No, it is a compliment. But to then want
to... Well, to actively push myself, yeah.
So what would you... So if you had to choose a tattoo or piercing, what would you get done?
Yes, good chance.
Well, I don't know, this is the problem, isn't it? Piercing's probably ear. Do you know what I mean?
I don't know if I can sit... You'll have earphones on, I guess. I was about to say, I couldn't sit across from you.
Look, can I just say, I'm not going Big Pat Butcher. Oops.
I really don't...
Like, it would be like a stud.
Like Captain Jack Sparrow.
And I'd probably be asking, even though it's like 2023 and I've not been in school for like 15 years, I probably would ask. I'd just be like, just to be sure, which one's the gay ear?
If I'm... Both. Both. If you just get in one, you would look less gay with both, in my opinion.
Or you think both would be better?
I personally think both is better.
Well, I've only got one.
Yeah.
I rest my case.
It's on my list. Tattoo, I don't know. It'll probably be somewhere on the upper arm, maybe.
I won't lie. I can 100% see Jake being the sort of person who ends up with a Prince Albert. I don't know why. I just see it.
He wouldn't put himself through the pain. No. That's the only reason I'm not, I disagree.
I'm not letting someone holding a needle come within anywhere near my genitalia.
Unless you're someone who's going for the rocker look as a man, your piercing should be hidden.
Do you think?
I personally...
No. You don't want to get it anywhere that can get like caught.
Yeah.
Well, you run the risk with that anywhere.
Like, I wouldn't have a nipple piercing just because of the exercise I do. Like, I feel that would just be inviting danger.
Me too. Oh, no. I've never liked the idea of piercings.
But it's on there. It's a piercing or a tattoo.
What tattoo would you get?
I don't know. This is the problem. I'd have to really think about it. My thing with tattoos has always been, look, I'm not that arsed about... I'm not necessarily against getting one, but it's like there's nothing that means enough to me or that looks good enough to me that I would be like, I want that.
No, I remember being really afraid. I've always been afraid of pain. But when my dad passed away, I was like, he had a tattoo of the Reiki symbol on his left arm. And so I was like, I would get the exact same tattoo in the same place as like a remembrance thing. So that was the only reason I initially got one. And then this one was so my sister could practice tattooing. That was the first time she'd ever picked up a tattoo gun.
Does she do mates rates?
Well, she did it for free. You're offering to be a test dummy?
I'll think about it.
Can we do like the blind tattoo where Jake gets blindfolded and it gets tattooed on him because he doesn't get a choice?
This ain't impractical jokers, mate.
The boys get to pick it. At least me and Ash.
No, what's one going to end up with chat shit? Get banged on my chest.
Dave still owes us that.
He promised it, right? Didn't he promise that tattoo?
100%.
He promised us that tattoo. During the Euros, he said, if Vardy scores and we win in the game against Wales, I'm going to get chat shit, get banged, and tattooed on my chest.
We were losing to Wales at the time. At the end of the first half, I think it was, we were losing to Wales. And then Vardy scores the equaliser and Sturridge scores the 90th minute
winner. Sturridge.
But he never defined that. So then we were... On the WhatsApp group, we're like,
Where's
your tattoo, mate? We'll pick it in for you.
If I was him, I would just get it small.
Even about a year later, I was still chasing it. I was like, mate, there's fucking tattoos.
I still chasing it.
And the thing is, look, he's married and settled down. His missus, you know, what can she do?
Book him in for a tattoo.
I won't lie. I would accept at this point if he just got like CSGB.
That equally, I don't know why, but to me that screams like code for racism. Do you know what I mean?
What do you think it stands for?
I don't know, but it would look like you're part of some kind of gang.
Well, no, but he'd be getting it on his chest, so any person seeing, well, no, he does get naked a lot.
They get naked a lot. Like, if any one of us was going to be seen
with racist tattoos, Dave.
Let's be fair, well, Dave is allergic to clothes.
Yeah, he is allergic to clothes.
He is.
The first time I think we went around there. I think I'm not going to name their kids' names on air or anything, but their eldest was maybe like one and a half, and just suddenly came running out, threw their clothes off, and it was like, well, we don't need a paternity test, Dave. That is your kid. Like, we.
Even at football, though. So, like, I think a couple of years before you started playing our football team, he like came in. Went in straight into the kit bag, got the tiniest pairs of shorts I've ever seen, threw them on, and then walked around the whole time. Like, literally, they were smaller than his boxers. And was like, yeah,
look, he's proud of his body.
Listen, if there was a kit clash, he'd be the first to call skins.
Yep. And like, look, I'm going to throw it out there, guys. He's got a nice body. Do you know what I mean? I'd flaunt it.
It's fair enough.
Yeah. No, go with it.
Body positivity, bro.
Yeah, I think we should be body positive. And
we've said people have been going after Sam Smith for it.
Sleeping with Dave is probably not on my 31 at 30. If I'm
really?
Honest.
It was on mine.
Dave will be very disappointed now.
I just feel like it's not much of a challenge. I like...
You're right. It was relatively easy.
But yeah, anyway. That's my 31 at 30 tattoo or piercing is definitely...
What else
there.
Is on there?
I think I told you I'll spend a day or a morning or in like a naturist reserve.
What, nudist?
A nudist colony.
Really?
Because I'm not very comfortable in my
nude
form.
You look like someone who's already been to one.
I've never been to one.
And I just think, as someone who's not very comfortable
Make
in my nude
that
form,
what you will.
It would be a great way to push me out of my comfort zone and kind of get comfortable with it.
Yeah, that would be a very...
It's very immersive.
Like, rip
immersion
the band off
kind
way
of thing.
To sort
yeah.
of be comfortable with who you are.
Something as simple
Where'd you look?
in their face.
Yeah,
like,
in their eyes.
In their eyes. Like, no, in their face, like they're a normal human
I'm
being.
I'm not going to not look at men's knobs.
That like says more about you.
Yeah, I'm not saying.
The thing is, look, it's easy not to look at your cock right now. Do you know what I mean?
Do you know what? Now I think about it. Were you on Tony's stag do?
No.
Because you did spend a long time looking at my crotch. you commented on it a lot in the Barbie outfit.
Yeah, there was a lot of crotch.
I like,
we all know when I drink, I get gayer.
I was about to say, yeah, that is like, true. You nearly nicked Dave from Mia when he was wearing that ginger wig on his
head. Oh, yeah.
Like, you were all over him.
Cardiff got bad.
You were all over him.
Bournemouth, you were very horny.
Was it Bournemouth?
Yeah, Bournemouth was Dave.
Cardiff was Tony's, wasn't
Cardiff
it?
Cardiff was Tony's.
Yeah. I remember waking up holding hands with Dave next morning.
Which time or both?
His stag do. Who got married first?
Dave.
Yeah, Dave's. Because I didn't get to go to the wedding.
Did you not?
No, I remember I flew out to Zante the day of
the
wedding.
Yeah, you did.
Oh, yeah, because I think I called you, I think.
Yeah, I think we
did have a few drinks and decided that you should be.
Plus, you guys
part
did a
day.
Synchronized dance with Dave, didn't you?
Yes, we did.
Yeah.
What was the song?
It was a mix match.
Yeah, we kind of did our own.
That's got to be on WhatsApp somewhere.
I'm hoping it's very deep. I remember
it's a memory for the day. Yeah. Okay. It's a memory.
I remember doing
the day.
Rehearsals for that, and then Dave. We're like spoiling all the things here, but Dave kept going. I can't, like, he'd only turn around the, like, 20 minutes before we were going to rehearse and tell us whether or not he could come because he couldn't leave Mia. He had to, like, lie to her, basically.
Where he was going. So he was risking her thinking he was having an affair.
Yeah.
I remember choreographing it. I remember being, I think it was at the park.
Who choreographed it?
Well, this is the thing. So we were like, okay, what are we doing? And he was like, he's sort of like, I don't know, like, something. So we had to, like, try and work out dance moves and work out if we could do them and then work out if we could kind of sync them like one to the next.
Yeah,
there was a lot of, I just remember planning it. So it was all of us. It was a group effort to choreograph it.
But Dave did like two rehearsals and went, well done guys, that's enough done. And I looked at him and was like, no, Dave.
We're not close. We're not close.
Near. You keep turning left. Everyone else is going right. We're nowhere near.
Nice. It was good though.
You wouldn't know you weren't there.
To be fair, I've
seen the video.
We were
very drunk by the time that we came around to do that.
A few drinks have been had.
So, like, I have no idea what happened at that point.
No, that's fair.
I remember I had knee pads on because of part of the dance routine involved me being on this dance floor on my knees, just cocking mouth. And I don't remember. I'd obviously had enough drink. I don't remember putting them on. I've no idea what taking them off, and I've no idea where they are. I've got a feeling they're still at that venue.
Probably.
Like, what did you take off?
I'll tell you where they are. It's only just come to me. I drunkenly, at the end of the night, asked someone, like one of Dave's relatives or something, to take them home, and I'll like pick them up off Dave at a later date. So I just like chucked them in this person's boot, and I've never seen them again. Knee pads. And I've never seen him again.
Yeah, because I think you had to do the worm or whatever at one point.
Yeah, when I was younger, I could do the worm with relative ease.
I remember making you do it.
Now, yeah, on concrete, thanks for that. I was content to do it on the grass, and you were like, no, do it on the concrete. And so I ended up with a big old purple bruise that took up the whole of my chin the next day, yeah. At that point in life, it was all of you. It was at a friend of ours in the garden.
Yeah.
On one occasion. And they were like, do you got to do it? You know, you said to do it, I'll do it. And I got to do it. And they were like, no, do it over there on the concrete. And it was
Why did you listen to us?
Because, you were drunk,
you
I was
some
drunk.
Self-responsibility, do you know what I mean?
I think we all know that self-responsibility is not something that I possess.
I don't think that's anything any of us possess, to be fair.
No, we're pretty low on that.
Not back in the day, especially.
Even now.
Although I've got a bone to pick with you about the past while we're on it. You deleted a video of someone... of them holding a rubber duck, and I
it's probably one of your greatest regrets, isn't it?
No, because I still stand and did that. I did the right thing.
No, come on.
I stand by
morality aside.
You can't tell
you
me you've
up.
Never regretted it.
Oh, every single day of my life. But I stand by the statement of I did the right thing at the time.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's a great video. Drunk.
Imagine that being played at the roast by Alex. Him somehow like Do you know what I mean?
That was the worst part, is I was the only person. Everyone else around me was like, no, keep it, keep it.
There's
keep
a general
it.
Rule. If a friend does something stupid, particularly under the influence of alcohol,
yeah,
you film it, you record it, and you make sure These that they lot, always remember,
remember
it.
You lot made me get my arsehole out.
In my living room.
Oh, that was in your living room as well. Yeah,
it
was in your living room.
I got so drunk that night.
Hammered. Well, we're the,
you must have drunk like a bottle of vodka.
I did. Yeah. And then, I know, 100% I did. I bought a 70cl bottle of Smirnoff and I bought orange juice, I think some lemonade, and I was like, I'll just have Harvey Wallbangers all night. Do you know what I mean? Within, I think, 2 hours maybe of being there, the vodka was gone and I was starting on cider.
I think you went outside for a cigarette because we don't smoke in my house. And then apparently you went on like a 20-minute walk and fucked off for 20 minutes and no one knows where you went. And you were like, I got lost.
I remember like just laying down at the, because you had like, you live in a top floor masonette. Yeah. And I was at the bottom of the stairs and I was just laying there smoking. And I actually phoned my now fiance, who was with another man at the time.
Boo.
And I was
unethical, bro.
Come at me. Fiance now. Yeah. That means it's all valid.
It was unethical.
All fair in love and war.
No, fuck that. It was unethical. I'm challenging you.
I'm proud of myself.
Says the only man who's not got a fiance at the
time. Oh,
oh wow.
Shots fired.
Can I just say? Right? When we had Alex on a few episodes back now.
Yeah.
And I didn't like the fact that he came on and challenged us. I'm getting the same vibe.
To be fair,
I don't like this.
40 minutes in is pretty good. Before you start getting assaulted.
I don't like it.
Oh, I'm just playing nicely this time, so you bring me back.
I got to be honest. Speaking of being engaged, I remember being like, Andrew's engaged? Like, I don't know. I just never imagined, particularly at such a young age. I always
what
thought
you
you'd... I thought, always thought you'd 16, have to be older.
You know?
What do you mean? Hold on. How long have you been engaged?
How long have I been engaged?
You probably got engaged about the same age that he was.
If not younger than me.
Yeah.
No, but look, I never pictured you getting engaged at a young age. You've always been quite a set in your ways kind of guy.
And I found a woman who's even more set in her ways and beats me up, and I don't have a choice anymore in life.
Yeah, and I pay women good money for that. So who's really
do you know
winning?
What? Any man that hasn't accepted that the role is second
is very true.
Is a fool, honestly.
It's a man who's lying to himself.
Yeah. They hold the keys.
It's the only way you'd have it.
Does this count as misogyny?
Technically, but it's true.
Oh, right, okay. So we're on that level now where we're like, well, yes, it's racist, but...
Well, no, but it's not racist. It's misogynistic.
Where do we end? Where do we draw the line here?
Oh, but like,
before you know it, can we just check their numbers? They're not like Britain First listeners, are they? What circles are we getting numbers in?
Look, I might have been posted on some questionable pages... Like MAGA groups,
and we've just
incels are us,
and we've just said like we were all at the same venue as the UKIP party conference.
That's not our fault. That's Tony's.
That was just complete happenstance. They weren't happy about it as much. Do you know what I mean? Like they didn't want a fucking stag do.
I think the only thing they were happy about when we walked in as a group of young lads on a stag do is that we were predominantly white. That was probably the only thing that pleased them.
Was it that stag do we happened upon? Like it was a trans/drag night.
Yes.
A local pub. It was that one.
In the downstairs thing.
Yeah.
Dave was dressed up as Misty.
Yes.
and then on top of that, we have one of our friends who got, it was when Pokemon Go was big.
Yeah.
And we were all dressed up as Pokemon.
Oh, was that night?
Then and he got chased down the street.
Someone came up to him and went, I'm going to catch you. Instead of being like
but he
a
did
normal
that to
person.
All of us. Like, yeah. He did that to me and he went, I'm going to catch you because I've got the
like,
Charmander thing
didn't
on.
Didn't he yell
and
like, he just, you'll never catch me?
He just, yeah, he just grabbed me and went, got you. And I was like, yep, yeah, well done, mate. Now enjoy your night. And he moved on.
Then he went on to the other person who and went, I want to catch you, Pikachu. And he went, yeah, right, you ain't catching me. And then bolted. So the bloke just chased him for like 20 minutes.
Didn't he end up hiding in the toilets?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Good night.
Great night.
Good night.
But yeah.
You got any more questions?
I've always got more questions. How politically engaged are you? Because I found it quite interesting and we've started having quite nice conversations outside of the pod because you listen to the pod.
Sorry,
you for that.
Can you just do the car brake thing? You know, the.
I've got to find it, Brian. Why'd you do this to me?
Because it's
like
it's
got
fun.
Like a whiplash.
Right. What's this you're talking to other people?
Look, Brian. Sometimes when you have urges, you have to look elsewhere.
I know about those urges. You don't tell me I don't know about those urges.
Just look at him.
I'm just saying, like, it's not cheating if I talk to both of you. It's not technically
cheating. I knew me and him weren't exclusive. I knew I wasn't his only text exchange.
It's just come as a bit of a shock that you're talking to other people outside of this.
Well, you've seen me on a night out. It shouldn't be a shock.
I wouldn't be shocked if I came in and you had, like, multiple penises in your mouth. That wouldn't be a shock.
For it to be a shock?
Honestly, let's think about this. Like,
depends on how much hentai he's been watching. That's the only defining factor.
I would say, like...
gone off of that since I've got older, got to say.
Hentai's a cartoon porn, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah, anime porn.
Yeah, okay, cool. But isn't hentai like tentacles?
Some of it.
Okay.
I don't know why you're looking at me like I'm the expert.
You brought it up. You brought it into the conversation.
I've always thought you were into anime and stuff.
When I say anime,
I don't just mean porn.
Are you just playing it coy because you know your fiance might listen? She might be like, I'm not getting tentacles.
I like the old school. Like, I watched like Dragon Ball Z and stuff.
I don't remember those episodes of Dragon Ball Z.
Like, I'm not massive. Like, I'm not watching.
No,
like,
Dragon Ball Z is awesome. Love Dragon Ball Z.
Are we just talking but about then, regular anime now? We're not yeah, talking yeah, about yeah. porn.
But then yeah. I like.
Okay, I thought we were talking about porn.
No, they've got
different names. So anime is anime, and then the porn version of it is hentai.
Yeah, I thought very we were still separate. Talking about
oh right, is that
I
how
we were talking yes. about hentai? Right. I didn't realize we switched to anime.
Well, I did say the word anime.
So like, yeah, all, to me, all the old they're all just you know
all the old school Japanese. So like Yu-Gi-Oh, Pokemon, Dragon Ball Z, all of those are anime.
Do you know what we had come into the shop recently at the charity shop, sold online, dirt cheap as well, because the person who processed it didn't know what they were. A pack of pristine, like first edition, not first edition, but they came out when the show first came out, Beyblades.
Oh God, I remember that. I loved Beyblades.
I liked Beyblades.
I was such a nerd, man. Like, we played Yu-Gi-Oh in school.
We were those nerds.
Yeah. We used to have to like go to like fucking the T block at school.
Do you know what though? Can I just be honest?
Because it was like the only safe place we could go with our cards.
You'll defend yourself on this, and now that you're here, you can defend yourself on this. That's not the saddest card game I've seen you play.
No.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah, that was a weird moment.
That was a very weird moment.
I still don't understand. The other person denies that it ever happened.
Well, he's lying.
Yeah, I know he is.
It happened.
But yeah, at a party, we walked in.
I mean, yeah, I will grant you this. Like, drinks has been had, and that like no one knew what I was doing.
It was
but you didn't drink at that time.
I didn't drink at this time. So
someone just said, "Let's play a game."
So basically,
I would, because the only thing I used to drink at that stage was energy drinks. So I'm off my nut on energy drinks.
Oh, I remember what used to be like on Relentless.
So I can't sleep. It's like 3 a.m. The party's finished. I don't know what to do with ourselves. So for some reason, he is still up awake as well. I don't know. And he's pissed. And we ran out of things to do. So the only thing we could do, we could basically be like, we can play poker, but we don't have anything to use as like tokens. So then we started.
So the only option is, let's play strip poker.
Yeah. But it got into a weird point where it was basically we went to like, the pants aren't coming off. So every time we got to the point where it was like done, because you've only got like a few bits of clothing, we'd have to then start again.
Even fewer.
she was sitting there undressing and getting redressing over and over.
I think we just took the clothes off and they were just used as giant tokens.
I think you've done so well to get to adult life without being groomed.
I played a lot of poker, that's how.
Yeah, that's probably the saddest card game I've seen you play.
Yeah. Oh, dear.
Are you politically engaged?
Did I ask that?
Yeah, you did, yeah. And we've been on every tangent.
When you asked that, I was like, how did you know I wanted to ask that?
Yeah, ask
in your mind.
We started with the question of, are you politically engaged, and ended up with playing strip poker. I don't know how that
Wait, one second. It was as equally applicable when you asked it as when
That's
I asked
how it started,
it. That is
to be
how
fair.
It started, because you were, yeah, it just went from there.
So, I think on the spectrum of left, because I'm probably the leftist here out of the lost.
And I got to admit, I was genuinely surprised, because not that I thought you were like extreme right or anything, just more that I didn't expect you to be politically engaged at all, I guess. Like, it was like when we were like closest, neither of us were particularly into politics. No. It was not something we ever spoke about.
Yeah, grown since then.
So when suddenly you were like, yeah, I'm like a I'm on the left. I was like, what the fuck?
Like, I just...
And also, sadly, my experience of some of our friends as we've grown up is disappointing in that regard.
It's just the way that it is. Some people want to take interest in it, and I think that nowadays you have to take interest.
I think some people know
what's going on, or else it's easier.
I don't think you can...
Some people have fallen victim to the tabloid offerings.
Yeah, I just think... I remember the adverts when I was a kid. I don't know if you remember them, of like... There was a bloke complaining, oh, can you believe the price of the petrol at the moment? And the price of this and the price of my pint. And the guy was like, did you vote?
Yeah.
And he was like, no. And he was like, then shut the fuck up, basically. And
I don't quite think of that. Like, I think a lot of the stuff that's done, and tabloids do this a lot of the stuff, like the boats at the moment, is that it's a big shitstorm that's made to distract people and keep them off of what they actually want to focus on.
Yeah.
And there's always something going on. You know, I think a lot of it, and trying to explain to a lot of people that are like, well, I can't vote for Labour because this reason, that reason, I'm going to vote for Tories and they're on the breadline. And you're like, you're literally bending
over.
Well,
look at the people in Leicester. One of the, from what I've heard, not one of the most salubrious of areas or richest of areas. They've just voted to keep them in as they're one of the only places in the country that chose to. So, like, there's people out there, sadly, that believe it. I mean, I think one of the easiest ways I would advise anyone to see whether they can trust one side or the other is watch PMQs and watch the questions a prime minister is asked and the lack of answers they give. And that just gives a huge indication of how honest they are.
I also think it comes down to looking at multiple sources, because I think you get a lot of problem at the moment nowadays. And I'm in like a science background, so a lot of my stuff is like the general idea of science is that someone makes an idea or hypothesis and then you have to prove that it's right, and that's taken, if multiple people around the table can prove that's right, then it's taken as fact and moved on.
I always like to think of myself as having quite a scientific mind, and it was always, you know, once you have a hypothesis, the aim is to prove it wrong. Because if you can successfully prove it wrong, then your hypothesis isn't any good. So you don't cater the experiments, whatever the experiments be, whether they be social or whether they be more in a lot of lab based or whatever, you don't cater them so that you might succeed in your hypothesis. You cater them so you're trying to break your hypothesis and hope that your hypothesis is strong.
It's kind of in the middle of that. You're saying this is what I think is going to happen, and then you look at the results and then you have to analyze it. And if multiple people do the same test and get the same results, then that's taken as fact for now until someone can prove something else down the line. But you get a lot of things nowadays with like BBC that they'll bring some random person on who's like,
they've got no credibility whatsoever.
They are self-catered, anti-vax or something, and they're like, well, we've got to listen to them.
This thing of balance, if there's a scientific truth that is sort of relatively undeniable, like vaccine, the effectivity of or flat earth,
I
or
think
climate change
in general, I'd agree with. I think there's conversations about the COVID one that need to be had. But
that in general, and you know, when there was the whole thing, even before, they're talking about vaccines. You know, that it's linked to people like, it's linked to autism, climate change, that stuff that's like pretty undeniable. Yeah. There's the scientific evidence all proves in that direction. You don't need to bring someone on who doesn't believe in it for balance. That's not balance.
And that's not them doing their...
That's misrepresentation, because you're now offering a falsehood.
Yeah. Yeah,
as an equal argument.
I think the problem is perhaps what these organisations would claim they understand is that there are people out there that sadly believe in flat earth or are anti-vax, so they have to represent another side that does exist, whether it's...
But the problem is
you're validifying their claims.
Oh no, look, I agree with you. This is what I think those
organisations
would say. Yeah. No, I agree with you.
But I think that's the same concept with news and stuff, is you've got to look in multiple places and not look in the same. If you're only watching Fox News,
when you can have a channel called GB News,
that isn't a news channel.
But yeah, it claims to be a news channel when it advertises itself as a news channel.
And like papers that like hard follow certain sides, they're on certain sides.
Yeah.
It's easy. I think it's easy for people to fall in the trap of that and not know 100%. What they're listening to. And I don't blame people for that. I think it's
tribalism at the same time as well, because once people identify a certain way of thinking,
it's us and them.
I think people get embarrassed to admit they might have been wrong about something, or, you know, judged by others.
There's a clip that comedians seem to really enjoy by a comedian called Ian Stone. Okay. And it's just him at like the Comedy Storm, and he's like, it's just an opinion thing. He says, all my opinions I get from other people. And he says, and sometimes you get caught out because someone will ask you an opinion on something. You're like, oh, I don't know. I haven't heard an opinion on that yet. What's yours? And then they go, he goes, yeah, that's quite good. I'm going to have that. Mm. And then you go and it turns out to be wrong. And you're like, you've made me look a fucking tit there.
Yeah.
And I do think it kind of works because I think a lot of people are like that. No one really has their own opinions. They take it from where they've heard it.
I think we are all like that. I think
us too. Like me too.
I do. It's like a lot of.
But I'm prepared to admit I think when I've been wrong.
And yes. social media as well is a big thing on this.
Like, yeah, I'm not big.
Oh God, yeah.
They are. You know, they're algorithms that are driven to get you to engage more and
yeah,
more.
Yeah, they're rabbit holes.
If you like something, you are literally going to end up with an echo chamber.
Oh, 100%. Yeah. Like, you've only got to look at one website of something and suddenly all your videos on your Facebook will be of that thing. And it's mental.
I had an argument with a friend of mine over something, and it wasn't the principle.
I don't like this fact that we've all got friends. I don't like. I'm not a fan of this.
But it was around the time the women's got to the first like semi-finals or final in the thing, and they were putting up stuff like, this is the first time an England football team has made it to a final or whatever since whatever, and they were like kicking off about it. And then I whittled off, well, we'd won the under 21s, we'd won the under 20s,
yeah,
World Cup and stuff, and I was like. When you just like see something, you're like, yeah, that's right, and instantly share it. You're feeding into that problem. There should be a moment of, hold on, before I share something, hold on.
Oh my God.
Is this accurate? I do that all the time, though. Like, the amount of times I don't hit tweet, or do you know what I mean?
Yeah, try and keep your timeline. You're trying to curate your timeline.
Yeah, like, I'll go to type something out, I'll see something, and something pisses me off, and I'll like reply, and I'll be like, that could be, someone could say this, and then I haven't really got a response. So then I end up just not. Tweeting it.
Have you seen the Metropolitan Police, by the way, when they got fact checked by Twitter?
No.
So you know Twitter now comes with this like fact check thing. The Met Police did a thing about, like, you know, arresting the night watch team, the women's night watch team, who hand out rape whistles and saying that they thought they were going to use them to disrupt the coronation and like basically like fuck the horses off and cause chaos. And the Twitter's actual fucking, like, this is the Met's defense, and Twitter like fact checked it and were like, police horses are actually trained to thing. Also, like, a lot of the horses that were there that day had like fucking trumpet players and drum players on the back of them. There's no way that loud noises are going to get spook them. Yeah,
I won't lie, that was my favorite part of the coronation, was watching the horses. You know when they go down the mall and you've got that really long shot, it was all the horses that just started,
they do not dress up.
They would like randomly turn and start going sideways, and they're like, I can't handle the pressure of being here and on TV, and they're like, no, I'm off. That was my favorite bit.
Yeah, I didn't watch any of it, I was working.
But yeah, no, Twitter fact checked the Met.
Yeah,
I loved it.
They're not doing well at the moment.
They're doing really badly.
Oh, dumpster fire.
Did you see the one where they killed two dogs?
Yeah.
Poor bloke and his two dogs.
Are we talking about the police or Twitter?
The police.
Oh, okay. I was talking about Twitter.
I mean, Twitter's a fire. Did you
go in with my job here being in like IT security and stuff? Did you hear that they just like turned off 2FA?
What's 2FA?
So 2FA is which you should...
Do I need to strap myself in? Am I going to get scared?
No, not really.
So you are, right. Given that you struggle with primary school education, this might be an intermediate level for you, bro.
Have you heard of 2FA, Jake?
No, but I'm prepared to learn about 2FA.
So 2FA is basically...
Get stuck.
This is sit down with Uncle Andrew and let's do lesson time.
What's 2FA?
Can I just say, given I know it's unfortunate you can't help your name... But let's definitely not sit down with Uncle Andrew. given we were just talking about the coronation, there's just a lot of...
That's true.
A lot of negativity around that.
Look, he's brought a bad name to the name. Do you know what I mean?
He's ruined the name.
It's only because he can't swear. It's the only reason.
I've got all the sweat. Do you know what I mean? I feel like I got his sweat that he couldn't have.
Yeah, sorry, 2FA.
So 2FA, so two-factor authentication, basically.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah.
It's the, you know, when you sometimes type in your password and then it will text you a code.
Look at this prick coming on here.
2FA, like, we knew what that was. I didn't know what 2FA meant, but I knew what two-factor authentication is.
Sorry.
Twitter just turned it off. They just decided it wasn't required anymore, and they turned it off for a little while.
Look, I think Elon's just fucking around with it for a bit. I think he's just seeing what happens, trying things out. He's pissing off a lot of people.
Have you seen that viral tweet from a coder? And he was like, you know, when Elon invested invested in the cars and the Tesla. People said he was a genius. I don't know anything about cars, so I went along with it. When he started doing the SpaceX thing, I don't know anything about rocket science, I went along with it. But now that he's on Twitter and he starts talking about all the various coding and stuff for it, I actually know quite a lot about this. And I know that man is definitely not a fucking genius.
No, he's not.
And no, he's not. I've listened to how actually he's made his millions, and it's all through subsidies.
Yeah, it's
through
it's
government subsidies.
So he's only turned profit. Tesla as a company's only turned profit once.
Yeah, and he didn't even start Tesla. Really? He didn't even found Tesla.
What?
No, he bought into it later.
Who
on.
Founded it?
Well, these two blokes.
T and Les. Yeah. I don't know.
Good old Les.
These two fellas founded it, and he just bought into it.
He bought into it, and then managed and then managed
didn't
to
do that
oust
with PayPal?
Yeah, he bought PayPal.
Yeah.
Yeah, fair enough. I mean, look, he took his
dad's
well for himself,
took his dad's diamond money.
Yep.
Well, look, we
just bought companies just that were already successful.
Look, we've just had a coronation. You know, let's not worry about the blood diamonds at the moment. We'll deal with them.
As Brits, we're obliged to leave.
We'll go back to the old man who didn't pay any inheritance tax.
Look, sometimes you've got to grease the wheels, bro.
I told you, I'm more left. If you find an angle, I'll find something to vote on.
I would, if I had to put my finger in the air, I'm assuming you're anti-monarchist.
Yeah, very much.
Yeah, fair enough. It wasn't a hard guess.
You imagine we had lots of talks about the coronation around the gym, and they were all positive.
How much you were looking forward to it, I imagine.
I watched it just to take the piss out of it the whole time. Yeah.
Is your missus into it?
That's a good question.
I don't think she cares.
Fair.
Did she watch it with you?
Yeah, but I don't think she cared.
That's fair.
I think we just like the day off, if I'm honest. That's
what about
what
your parents?
Yeah, we all watched it. We had afternoon tea.
Oh, nice.
Afternoon tea?
Afternoon tea.
Who are you?
His mum would
have made it. Who are you?
What do you mean?
I mean, who?
Afternoon tea is eating sandwiches and scones. Like, what do you want from me?
Well, to be more working class, when have you started eating afternoon tea?
I've been to afternoon tea.
I don't think
we can discuss this on a future episode. What are you talking? Like, you're doing afternoon tea now.
It's delightful.
We're not getting silver plaque. We're waiting ourselves. It's not like, you know, we got the butler. We're not in your house with a
salmon
butler
and cream
round.
Cheese.
Yeah, my
you know what he's upset about? It's the fact
he
wasn't invited, and his butler was like, "Sir, I can do afternoon tea."
Mate,
like,
just
no,
stop beating your butlers again.
It's a bit of a grey area while the police investigation's ongoing.
Fair enough. Already getting done for human trafficking. Don't want to add abuse to it as well.
None, like, you can't talk about that till the case is over.
Shit, sorry. I'll mute this bit.
You've got a long list of notes there. What? You got any highlighted notes? Have you got any, like, big bad boy notes? Have you got anything light? Anything?
I've got one. You know what it is.
Yeah, I think
I ask this to everyone who comes on the pod, right? And it'll be less awkward with you because unless you didn't tell us when we asked how your dad was, he's still alive.
oh, shit. I asked at the start if he's got cancer. Is your dad alive?
My dad is very much alive.
Is your mum alive?
You just went, he's fine. that could mean anything. I can imagine him being dead and you just going, yeah, he's fine.
Well, he's fine. He's not got anything to complain about. Exactly. All his ailments have gone.
Right. So the question is, it's a would you rather. So every time you wash,
yes,
your dad has to wash you for you. So we're talking flannel job every inch. Or every time he washes, you have to wash him.
I feel like my dad has seen me enough times naked that at this point, I'd rather just be lazy and let him wash me and be done with it.
What is wrong with people? That's two people we've had on now that have...
The difference is, either he can see my manhood and he has to be mentally scarred by that, or I can see his and then be mentally scarred by that.
You tell me you've never seen your dad's knob?
No, why would I see my dad's knob?
Well, yes. I have.
Well, you've
wait,
seen
you've
his
seen
dad's
my dad's knob,
knob
or your dad's knob?
Both.
What happened on that holiday?
Have you not seen your dad's knob?
Yeah, when I was younger, probably.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, but that's what I'm talking about.
I'm like, I'm just doing for the laziness and just
like,
be like,
the way I did it in my head, because I was complete opposite, I was like, I'll wash my dad if he was still here.
Rippers.
You can't play that card every single time.
I absolutely will. what was I saying? You interrupted me.
You Rippers, and your dad being naked bathing.
Your thought process.
Oh, you've just thrown me by.
Yeah, your thought process behind it. Your defence of what your answer was.
Oh, was it what would be easier to explain to people? Like washing my.
But I said to you at the time, why are you explaining it to people? Why do people need to know?
Walks in on
who's walking in on you?
It's your house.
It's like it's weird enough that this is.
Are you going to a swimming pool? Are you going out to a public swimming pool? And then your dad just
feels easier that way. It feels easier that way.
This is our bonding ritual. This is people. It's only weird if you stare.
Other people join in.
Just going up to the wanderer and stripping off your clothes.
I think you might need to invite. Because that might be the nature reserve thing there that he wants to go, you know, the nudist
thing. Is he's already been naked around me enough. I'm comfortable with his body.
I think we talked about this. I don't think we've ever been naked in each other's presence, have we?
More or less. I've been in a towel around you.
I've
seen you in speedos. I feel like that's close enough.
I feel like I've been in both of your naked presence.
Have you? I don't know.
Well, yours probably from football.
Yeah, possibly.
That's close enough in the change room, and yours just from being you.
Look, sometimes
clothes are restricting.
Yeah, they are. Look, I'm on Dave's side some of the time. In certain places with people you trust, you know, clothes should be optional.
Can I just thank you, by the way, for taking that question seriously and running with it? You did. At no point did you say that's a stupid hypothetical.
No, because this
just
little bitch,
it.
When I asked him, was like, "Ah, oh, how could you even ask me that? That's disgusting."
It is, I stand by it. But thank you for taking
Even
it seriously.
Even my sister answered it.
Yeah, but I don't know why your sister's getting involved with washing my dad.
Well, he's a handsome man.
The real question
be rude
is,
not to wash him.
The real question is your sister and you at the same time washing your dad?
Oh, yeah.
We'd alternate.
Oh, so you get a day off now?
Yeah.
But what?
Hold on. Just anyone, a sibling.
But what single pair, single children don't?
It's just...
So I've got to do it every
you're
day.
You're not
yeah,
a single
so he,
child.
He's got to do it every day.
I've got to do it every
it's
day.
It's just roll of the dice, isn't it? It's not... You could have had a sibling.
No, I would have eaten them.
Yeah.
What do you mean you could have had a sibling? Like it was his choice. Like it was his command.
Well, no, but like we don't choose whether we have siblings or not. It was just luck of the draw I did have one.
I like this idea of me.
You've got one, so what are you coming at me for?
I still don't want to wash my dad every other day.
You're going to get a day off every other day.
I like this idea in Big's world. It's me as a 2-year-old clicking my fingers at my parents. You please, yeah, come on, another one. I don't want to have to wash him naked every day. Get me another one.
I want days off. Twins, come on.
Sometimes you just gotta think ahead.
Would twins have to do it together because they're twins, or would
no,
they equally
alternate? Just alternate.
I feel like this is going way too far now into like the mechanics of this.
To be honest, I think if the siblings are doing it together, it's crossing into a weird.
It's crossing swords.
Yeah. This is crossing swords law now of this question.
We've never explored it. No. We've never asked that variation.
It feels like it needs a full episode on its own of all the various.
We could squeeze one out.
All the ins and outs, as it were.
That's might be a bit too far.
I've heard them questions as well. No, thank you.
What else have we got, boys?
What do you want me to read your notes?
It'd be helpful if you had some notes.
Freeform, baby.
I won't lie.
Freeform.
When it comes to the gym, he doesn't change at the gym. So when we go to the gym, I have to basically tell him, this is when I want to go. Can you come? Yes or no? And then we turn up to the gym. I have to tell him what we're doing and how many reps, and then track the weights for both of us.
Now, imagine trying to do a podcast with him.
The thing is, you're not that far off. Like, there is definitely an element.
I've
got a question for you, Big.
What's that?
So we've been hitting the gym. You've got four weights. What do you reckon he's doing now? So bench, deadlift, squats.
You're going to have to describe what those exercises are.
Wow. I'm trying to think of what's heavy. Do you know what I mean? Is it in pounds?
Kilos,
right.
So bags of sugar, effectively.
How much do I think Jake can bench press?
So what's your weight roughly for like a reference point?
58 kilograms.
That's how much you weigh?
Yeah.
Is that it?
Yep.
I reckon I could bench press you.
Yeah, you probably could. You'd have to build to it a bit.
I'd like to think you must be hitting... I'm trying to pick the number respectfully.
So
just remember, I'm like 5 foot tall.
I'd be disappointed.
I've
got to admit, I'm not taking... I'm putting myself...
Yeah. So just for reference... 70
kilograms.
Yeah.
Bent on what?
On his chest.
On bench.
On my chest bench. God no. Oh,
Jesus Christ.
God no.
Big's out here gymming like he's just Hulk.
Big no. Daddy Big probably can do 70.
No, do you know what? I'm mad because I couldn't lift a 50 kilogram door. I struggled with that. So yeah, thinking you're lifting 70. So what?
And talking? Doing like what? 10 so what are you doing?
20, bro.
You're closer than you are with 70.
He's lifting 20. What are you doing? All right.
First off, who do you think's doing more?
You.
Yeah, I'm doing more.
Well, of course you are. You're a bigger build.
Right. So.
No, but you're a lot broader than Jake is. You can support more weight.
So bench is the lightest of all of them because like deadlift is full body, squats is like pretty much full body, and then leg presses.
I don't know. Let's put it in more in perspective now. Because now I'm thinking, well, if you can't lift what I can lift,
why the fuck would I be able to?
So you must be doing what in general 30?
Yeah, you're pretty much.
I think
there.
32 and a half.
Yeah,
was what he was doing on bench.
I don't know what I'd be able to bench.
You'd have to do a couple of sessions to build to it just to get the technique and everything. I reckon
he could do 55.
I was thinking minimum 40. I was like, 40.
My max I think I hit was 50, and that was doing three sets of three reps, and I was struggling by the third.
Yeah, what was that weight? Sorry,
50 kilos.
But nice. But recently, with your sessions with me, you've not been doing 50. Now come on.
No, I did it on the free set. The one we did today was 47 and a half, and then I dropped it down to like 42 and a half.
What gym do you go to?
Westcroft.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, not far. That's fair. Just doxing ourselves now.
Yeah, basically. Giving out our own addresses, our own location.
We've talked about living in Wallington before anyway.
All right, mate, calm down.
Now you're connecting up the dots there, because not only do we know the place.
Well, you don't live in Wallington, you live in...
No, yeah, let's not go there.
Let me just check your address again. But yeah. Oh, nice one. So, I mean, I've been
optimistic. You didn't seem that
impressed at start. And then we started.
When it put into perspective, where it was like 20 kilograms. That's a sack of potatoes.
Yeah, but when you went straight into 70, and you've
well,
just
that's
said
the thing in my
lifting
head.
A 50 kilogram door, and you think I'm doing that plus a sack of potatoes,
I forgot
and doing like 10
and 10. With only your arms, like deadlift. If you've gone like deadlift like that, I'm like, okay, that's like full body, like I get it, but like just with your arms.
Yeah, I forgot about the door. Do you know what I mean?
I forgot about the door.
Yeah, I forgot about the door.
He did a reverse.
Life closes a door. You're stuck with it because it weighs too much and you can't lift
it. Well, no, I could lift.
You could lift it.
I was able to lift, I think it was, and I started struggling after that, was a 40 kilo door. But that also because it's an awkward shape.
Yeah.
So it makes it worse.
But yeah, the 51, I couldn't. It was fucking awful.
So we have both agreed that until we can basically deadlift you, we're not stopping.
But to be fair, that was after 6 months of not working.
Yeah.
You reckon you could deadlift, mate?
No, we're not stopping until we can.
Oh, wow. Fair enough.
I'm a bit off.
I don't think I'm that far on the leg press.
Yeah, I could imagine that.
I don't think so.
No, my legs are powerful.
Oh, that's got to be in the clip. Oh, that's got to be in the clip. Just that isolated on its own. My legs are powerful.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm benching.
Nice.
And then deadlift, and I'll just tell you the deadlift and the squats.
I can't remember squats.
The thing is,
I'm just doing my weight basically. I'm doing 60 and then 60.
That's really
two
good.
And a half.
Yeah. No, like I was gonna come across really condescending for a second and be like, for a man of your size. No, that is
you're not,
really
you're not wrong
really
though.
Good.
For no, a man of my size,
yes, it is that really is good. Really good.
I am bench pressing. I am deadlifting my weight, and I am
because I'm literally double the size of you, so I should be able to lift.
Yeah,
that's twice as much in theory. Yeah.
So, no, that's really good.
It's going all right. 7 weeks in or whatever.
Yeah, although we've skipped a couple.
Yeah, skipped a couple.
Why? What you've been doing?
I was moving out, and then. We did a week. We've repeated the last week and this week. We basically did it twice because
we tend to go first thing in the morning.
Okay, you first thing in the morning.
Yeah, six.
Well, that's
6:30.
What I'm saying, right? So because we tend to do that, What I'm not doing is if I'm not being, if what he's not going and I'm not being forced to do it, I'm not doing it.
What happened to Alex?
He's dropped off the wheel. He's coming back on it.
I sneaked in them DMs. I heard him being like, yeah, at Westcroft gym. I chatted to him at football and I went, I'm sneaking in these DMs.
Why not?
And
it's always Alex, better going with someone else.
Yeah.
You get consistency out of it. Yeah.
And also it's like,
and he keeps tracking
it, adds
me
a level of like, I don't want to let the other person down.
I think we've done I think in like 7 weeks or something, there's, well, obviously the week that we didn't do it because I was busy, but one time we were like, no, we're not feeling it. And both of us were not feeling it.
Yeah. Yeah. It was literally the night. No, the morning, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Woke up in the morning. It was just like, oh, it's just I not texted happening. Him at I'm six too in tired. The morning, and whatever.
Like, he was like, I was like, oh, it's not happening for me. And he was like, thank God it's not happening for me. Yeah.
I'm never upset to go back to bed at 6 a.m.
No, no one is.
No. But we keep bumping into, I've never really spoke to my neighbour goes there. Never really spoke to him before, but we keep bumping into him. He tends to go about 7-ish. So I keep saying, you know, keep sort of speaking to him a little bit. Get that, I feel like we're going to build up a good bond.
What, you and your neighbour?
Yeah.
I never liked the idea of that. I feel like your neighbours, this should just be a, you know, quiet respect. Just be respectful. It's not, I don't need to know your life story. Don't need to know your children's names.
I know what he benches, mate. I know. No, I don't. But I should. That'd be cool.
I know his gym workout.
I do know his gym workout.
Because you watch him.
Well, what you said like that sounds creepy. Yeah. What I do is I just sort of like observe with a healthy respect and note down everything he does.
Yeah.
And I don't tend to watch anything else. I don't think that's weird.
No,
it's just what you focus on.
It's just healthy. Yeah, it's just healthy.
This now explains what he's doing when he's forgetting to count my reps for me when I'm midway through a set and dying. And I'm like, what am I on? And he's like, three.
It's only happened once. Shiny.
Right, can I say that's only happened once that I've genuinely forgotten to keep count.
And then you could count yourself as well.
Yeah, no, he was. No, he was. And he was like, yeah. He was,
I turned around to get up and get done. And I was like, oh no, it was one more. I'd stopped for one more.
And I went, can't make it four more. I was like, come on, mate, last four. And he was like, four.
What?
He's like, you can fuck right off.
Yeah.
That's only happened once.
Yeah.
Which is quite a good record for me, to be honest.
Nice. I'm pleased for you guys.
Thanks, man. I believe it.
Oh no, I'm genuinely. Feels good.
It's just sometimes we take so many shots at each other, I think it's hard to believe.
No, I've anyone making good life decisions is a good thing.
I feel like what Jake wants is the round of applause for going to the gym.
Does he?
I think that's
well, for getting up at 6 a.m, like 5.
To be honest,
5:30 in the
every
morning,
normal
like,
adult should be able to get up at that time in the morning. But your health standards improving in general, I think you deserve this. Right.
Yeah. Mama like.
Mama like.
Mama like that.
I'm not finding that.
No, I don't expect you to. You got so many on there. You got so much on your plate. You've been carrying this pod for so long.
And carrying you, which we discovered isn't very difficult because you're quite light.
Yeah, there you go. Now you got no complaints, mate.
Yeah, I don't even know if it's still on it.
Especially now I know what your standard of gym, like you expect people to just go in and be like, bang, 70 kilos.
Oh, no, I found it.
Mama like that.
Well, like,
mama
look, bro, like I was that. Being optimistic for you.
You really were.
Just benching 70
kilos. Can you imagine going to the gym with him and he starts racking up for you?
What, the guy that we saw today, yeah. There's someone in there that was doing 180 kilos.
Fuck
so he
hell.
Had, like, the red plates, that's 25. He had two blue ones that are 20 each. He had a green one at 10. Jesus. And then a grey one on the side of this bar. And the bar itself is 20 kilos.
You don't need to be that strong.
No, I feel, yeah, there's
but he
limit.
Wasn't even head, like, he wasn't, he was big bloke, but he wasn't like.
Well, you don't need
head.
To be benching that much.
When he took, I was genuinely.
He's not benching that, he's deadlifting.
He's deadlifting. Jesus. But even that, like, 180 kilograms, but even still.
180, he's going, yeah, bench that.
Benching, mate.
Here you probably. Go, mate, bench that bitch.
Bicep curls. Yeah. No, but even think about it, right?
He's got that, he's got it in one hand. He's got the other arm is up and he's just doing one arm like fucking chin-ups with it, holding the weight.
Could you imagine?
But think about it. That's just straight up, just picking up and lifting and putting back down again and doing that, you know, what, 3, 4, 10 times?
Yeah.
180 kilograms.
We worked it out.
Three of me.
Yeah, it was three of him. It was basically him on my shoulders and then holding like a sack of potatoes. And the guy just went, boom, boom, there you go, done, easy.
Like it was seriously impressive.
Yeah.
It's terrifying.
Fuck that guy.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
That's something to aspire to.
No, I fuck that guy. If I went into the gym and Lil was genuinely like, look, we're going to go for the 180, I'd be like, mate, I'm going home. I'm not doing this.
I can't even do a pull-up. How do you expect me to do 180?
I was wondering whether you were going to do that this morning. He kind of like climbed up to the bar and just hung. And I was like, are you trying for a pull-up?
This was right at the end of the set as well, like the last set.
It's the worst time to try it.
Yeah, no, it wasn't happening.
That's fair.
It was just quite funny though. You did just sort of climb up and I was like,
can you do pull-ups?
I can do like two.
Okay. Yeah, his weight is... That's
doing more than me.
I was about to say, the weights he's throwing around in the gym aren't too far off what he weighs anyway, so he's not far off of it.
But I can't... Yeah, it's not easy.
It's not 70 on your chest.
No, mate. I'm not even going to report to you about how my gym's chest sessions are going until I'm hitting 70 on the chest.
When you hit 70, I want a gun show photo, do you know what I mean?
If I hit 70, I'll probably be dead. Crushed under the weight of it.
It's doable, surely.
It is doable.
Yeah, it's doable.
But I'm just setting the bar here, bro.
Yeah, but the problem is when I lift that bar off and bring it down to my own neck.
I'm going to die.
Yeah.
When the bar he's lifting is heavier than he is.
I believe in you.
At that point, are you lifting the bar or is the bar lifting you?
Like, the bar's lifting me. Yeah, the bar's lifting me.
It's Thor's hammer, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it would need to be.
Yeah.
And I need to be worthy.
Can I say now, and to slightly change the subject, and to continue pumping Jake's ego as I feel bad for him for
yes,
taking
please,
the piss.
Thank you.
How well he's been doing at football, 11 aside.
Thank
you. Was something I was going to ask was, how are you at football now? How is he at football
improving
now?
There's still a long way to go.
I think it was hard to begin with because I think that you'd never really played 11-a-side football.
Not consistently.
Men's football.
Not consistently.
And there's a big jump. Like, it's great to be playing, like, 5-a-side. But there's a massive change.
And now I can't do that.
But I think it massively improved to the point where you're now probably consistently a starter or definitely in the shout for starting each week.
So. The little nod from Jay, like, yeah. It's what it is.
Some of us got to play it cool.
Yeah.
We've got to try. It doesn't come naturally to us like Big Daddy Big.
No.
I've got to force myself. I enjoy playing with the talents
on the football pitch that I possessed. No one else knows what that's like.
I say I enjoy playing regularly, but we've like hardly had a game.
We say that big with this cool smile, knowing of the big up front strap.
Oh, yeah.
If anything, it was unfair to do that to the other team.
Devastating them.
Do you want to tell the story of how you remember that big front
have
strap?
We not told it before?
Possibly.
But basically, I was so bad at football and such a liability in defence that the team convinced me it was a good idea for me to be the main man up front to basically keep me out of the way.
Yeah.
I think we had...
I think you had some good attributes.
They were like,
you
hold the ball
job,
up.
You did do a good job.
Yeah, because I thought you lot believed in me.
I'll tell you now.
Why did I believe that?
I said this to you on the pod, and he can back me up now. Would do a better job than our current, or at least one of our current strikers.
Yeah, definitely.
I would not be
even in your
now.
Current... He doesn't. Current you're fine.
Yeah,
you're not competing with much on the movement front.
I reckon I'd have like maybe a 10-yard zone of terror.
Like
the guy doesn't have a 10-yard zone.
He'll say like, play it into my feet, play it into my feet, I'll hold it up, and it's gone.
So I don't know if I can leap like I used to either.
You don't have to. You're not competing. If you can keep the ball at your feet and pass it...
Just hand it to someone
better. You're winning.
I'm hoping he doesn't listen to the pod.
He doesn't even know it exists.
And before I tell this story, please don't tell him to listen to the pod.
Please tell him to listen to the pod.
But so we had an important cup game a couple of weeks ago and he was on the bench. He was on the bench and I helped run the team. I was making the subs and I said to him, can you go round, get the lino flag? Because the subs have to run it. Can you get the lino flag off this guy? When the sub comes off, I've got to make another change. He'll come and get it off you and then you'll be coming on straight afterwards. And he looked me dead in the eyes and he went, Andrew, mate, I can't run the flag. I'm going to pull something. And I looked at him like, what? You expect the lino flag to be harder work than going out on the football pitch and playing football? He was like, yes, mate. I'm going to pull something if you put me out on the lino flag. So I looked at him and was like, yeah, you either run the flag or you're not coming on the pitch. That's your choice. And he was like, he then sulked off to get the flag.
Because as you said, if I can't trust you not to pull something running, then you're going to pull something playing the game.
Yeah.
So you're not ready to go on.
Wow. How big is this guy?
About my height, slightly broader.
A lot broader.
I'm asking partly how fat is he?
I wouldn't say he's fat though. He's got a bit of timber.
Smaller than his lop.
He's got a bit of timber, but he's not like fat.
Just calling out his lop for being fat, a random drive-by, bless him.
I don't think that his lop cares too much.
No, he's got more important things to deal with.
Unless they play this in the pub, he'll never hear it.
That is very true. He's got to get out of the pub and not play poker for 10 minutes.
Is that what he's up to?
He works part-time in the pub now. Getting a little extra cash.
Fair play.
You didn't ask how his parents were, and you didn't ask whether he's got a second job.
Do you have a second
job? My job keeps me busy enough as it is.
That's fair. Well, I think that might be a pod.
Oh, shit.
Might be a pod.
But no, it's been a pleasure having you on.
Thank you for having me.
Didn't talk about half the stuff I wrote down, which I like. Because every time we go into one of these, I'm like, oh, fuck, well, we ran out of stuff to talk about.
Ended up being a lot more casual than I had anticipated. I was going to ask you a few questions. And I was, before you start thinking, like, oh, it's convenient to say you had questions.
At the end of the podcast.
Jake 100% did that thing of the homework. Yeah, I did my homework. It's right here. You just didn't want it.
I was going to ask you a couple of, like, sort of a bit more specialist IT questions, but I'm glad. I'm happy with the direction we went in.
I think we'll do that on the next one.
Hey, listen, you've been invited.
Because look, we did this sort of with Alex as well. The first one was just to shoot the shit, catch up, sort of introduce you to the people of the podcast.
the two people of the podcast.
Hey, no, our numbers are all right, bro.
I'll introduce you to the listeners.
Yeah.
Sorry, I thought you meant us.
Look, they're part of the podcast too, bro.
They're part of the family.
People in there, they're all part of it. And for anyone listening, you need to go on YouTube to see.
Very GCSE drama then. You.
You. But yeah.
No, he could have directed it.
But yeah, and then the second time we had Alex on, we had maybe a slightly more serious conversation. We talked to him about the strike. That just sort of all happened quite nicely. We were just having him back on. The strikes were happening.
Do you believe in podcast gods?
No.
That's a shame, because you should pray to them that he's managed to record it right this time.
Oh shit, it's not even recording.
Oh no, we have to do it all again.
Jake, tell them where to find us.
I'm not going to do the joke this time, I'm going to go straight. Right, you can find
You say
us.
That every time as well. You're like, it was like back in the day, Jake used to do like a monologue at the start or a joke or something. And he'd be like, do you know what, this week I'm just going to be Jake. And that then became the thing of like, I just couldn't be bothered preparing anything. So I'm just going to say this week I'm not doing a joke. So the new thing is I'm just going to play it straight.
He listens, he knows.
I remember the early days of Jake being everyone but Jake. And then one week went, I'm just Jake this week.
Yeah, and then never turned back.
No.
No.
I decided that I was comfortable enough in myself.
Look, we support your truth.
If you'd like to see how comfortable I am, you can do that on Instagram, CrossingSwords_podcast, on Twitter, at @SwordsCrossing. That nearly broke me then. That nearly made me corpse. I don't know why, but that nearly made me corpse. You can find us on Facebook.
What's cool?
Just Crossing, laughing. It's like it's a media term. So in like film and TV, if you break character and laugh,
right.
I think we're getting good enough numbers that we consider ourselves in the media industry. You can find us on, what have I done? Facebook, Twitter, Instagram.
I got distracted by your eyes.
Same handle, TikTok for Instagram at @CrossingSwords_podcast. CrossingSwords19@gmail.com if you want to get a little more personal. Tell us what you think about the episode. Tell
and
us
for
if
anyone
you've got any
who didn't
ideas.
Understand any of that, it will all be in the description of the episode as well.
Don't forget to like, rate, and share.
Yeah. Get on YouTube.
Five star of it, people.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? The man said it himself. You can't argue with him.
No. He's in charge right now.
No, he's got daily sex. You can't argue with a man with daily sex.
Never.
Can't spell it, though.
No. Can't spell five stars. But he can give us them.
You can give it.
You can recommend
them.
Yeah. He's laying pipe, folks.